I have my own passion for the music and the quality of the music making that I strive to share with the students.
That I wanted to be in this choir ever since eighth grade when I heard them sing at my school.
Like, I'll sit next to Eduardo or like some other really talented person, and of course my voice is gonna change when I'm sitting next to them because I have something to model myself, and like, they're my role models, they really are.
The challenge for me, taking them out into these places that are new to me, meeting new people, performing for new audiences all the time, just gives me a chance to challenge myself to make them as strong and as musical as I possibly can.
Next week we're leaving for our spring tour, which will be in Boston, Massachusetts, flying all of the students out there, roughly 85 students. Dr. Breden and Bruce Olstad and myself. The Boston tour was initiated, or was the first concept, of Father Thomas O'Malley when he was president. And upon his departure, now that he's back at Boston College, we have been given the invitation by him and Father Carroll to come out and visit them. So we're performing for 3 evenings. We arrive very late on Wednesday night. We have a free day on Thursday, and we perform Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday night, and return on Monday.
I think it's going to be great to be able to sing in like a variety of places other than the Sacred Heart Chapel. I mean, I love this place, but I think that being able to sing in like, you know, big old, you know, cathedral-like churches, I have this opportunity to go. It's like once in a lifetime. To be able to sing as friends and to have fun together as friends. So it's going to be an experience that we can all share together. We've worked hard for it, and we deserve it.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you got. Taking a break from all your worries sure will help a lot. Would you like to get away? Everyone!
Sometimes you want to go, and everybody knows your name.
It's really exciting because I can't wait to go to Boston because, like, I've never been to the East Coast before and I'm so excited.
So we're going to Boston.
Yes, we are going to Boston.
You want to go where people know. People are all the same.
I want to see if everybody knows my name. Where are we going?
Don't we need a ticket?
Yeah.
We're going inbound? Yeah.
What are we doing right here?
They don't take dollars either.
No, they do. They take dollars.
I don't have a dollar.
Yeah, neither do I. Emotion, that's what I need. No one can stop me when we take the lead. From the Eastern Ocean to the Western Coast. Gotta find the motion that can move me.
That's what I need. If we are ever gonna get up speed, I got the notion, made up my mind. A lot of locomotion, but I'm gonna find.
We were gonna walk up to like Harvard Square and get coffee and a muffin and then take the tea because it's the same amount and then you get food on the way.
Look out for the signal, I'll let you know when you should stop and when you should go.
I'll be going to one of these. You don't even have to say Harvard. You just say medical.
Together, where everyone is finally fully focused on what they're doing, and it's my job in those performances to make sure that everything stays put together, stays connected. If I hear things that are going a little bit differently than the way I hear them and that I want them, and I've trained the singers, I need to be able to work that in a concert and keep everything in line. And other times it rolls along beautifully and I can kind of almost relax in the way I conduct a concert and just let it flow. So it's a constant give and take for me to make sure that everything falls in place and hopefully the singers are all really in line with me and giving their best.
She likes to do on these tours is just get us to have a feel for all these different environments, and I think that's really cool.
I like the atmosphere of the church. I think it's nice to sing in like a church with the music we're doing. Like the music is very spiritual, and I think it's nice to have a chance to come all the way to Boston and sing in a different church besides just ours. I think it's just another opportunity to just have a new experience with singing.
There's something incredible about young people making beautiful music together. I just got to sit there and kind of sniffle all the way through because it's just so remarkable, so beautiful.
There has been a lot of music that we've performed that just gets you. And there's just no words to describe how you feel when you're singing in that choir. to this day, there are certain parts in there that just gives me goosebumps. We have this really beautiful sound coming out.
I think they make good music because they're enjoying being with each other.
There has been a long history of trying to maintain a certain kind of sound. It was developed in the Salamunovich years, in which Mary Breden has carried forward.
I think so much of my teaching, I hope, goes far, far beyond the music with the students, as we're trying to do the best possible music making that we can. I'm hoping that the lesson becomes a bigger one, and that is that striving for excellence, never settling for anything that is mediocre. We just don't have time for mediocrity. Just the right sound, or just the right vowel sound, or blending the voices so that no one voice is sticking out, or no syllable is unduly accented when it's not an accented syllable. Just that fine-tuned detail is demanding themselves of excellence. And I hope that commitment to excellence will carry through in anything that they do in their lives, whether they go on in music or whether they go on in any other profession in non-music, because we're dealing with music students and non-music students. Most of all, we're dealing with human beings, and I hope that this, in the long run, will just build to improve the quality of their lives and make them really solid, self-respecting human beings who also have a wonderful respect for everyone else and what they do. We've always had the motto that life is too short to sing badly, but life's also too short to live it badly, and I think that push for excellence has to be the end result, far beyond any music making. Hopefully they take that with them.